heroes over and over again, but now we're seeing first band Rikis, we're seeing first band Drows. A lot of variation from game to game.
Yeah, the last series, Elder Titan was completely ignored.
Yeah.
So, and that it's been like a first two pick for the most part for most teams in DC.
You gotta ban it against Secret, though. I really do.
Yeah.
Agreed.
After seeing the way they stalled the game yesterday, I think you kind of have to.
Yeah.
It was pretty absurd.
And I guess if you're DC, okay, so first pick Secret, so you almost have to ban the Drow as well, probably. Like, Drow ET seems like a decent...
They picked Winter Wyvern versus the Drow earlier today. And I think they're... Or was it... I don't know. We've seen Winter Wyvern, like, have a lot of success.
Yeah, first phase Drow lost two games in a row this morning. I don't think it's... And then it just lost in the last series. Yeah, I don't think it's necessarily unstoppable.
But Eternal Enemies, I think, is slightly better than... he has a slightly different playstyle than the other ones.
Yes. Yep. Yeah, they busted out Drow with Shanghai when no one even thought the hero was good. That was when everyone thought the hero was still crap, and suddenly they're fifth picking it and winning games. And then Team Sad banning. It was like that grand finals where Team Sad banning Drow.
Yeah, and there's the Drow ban once again. Now I think it's also worth noting that they put it mid yesterday, I believe, with the E playing it, and did a fairly good job protecting it. They had a pretty favorable matchup against a Tiny. Yeah.
It's a flexibility thing where often you may think your safe lane can get pressured and dived against certain teams, so. Being able to rotate Drow to the mid, where it's easier to protect Drow in the mid lane some games than in the safe lane.
So if everything goes to form, this will be first pick Shadow Demon. What do you guys think?
Yep.
There it is.
Mm-hmm.
So Digital Chaos get their pair of heroes. Beastmaster, a good possibility.
Yep. Beastmaster.
I like Void.
Void, yeah.
I like Void plus one. I mean, the Shadow Demon's good versus the Beastmaster and the Void in a way.
It's good against, like, all the meta picks is the thing. Yeah. That's where it's like, you can't just say, oh, you don't pick Void now because Shadow Demon's good against it.
Yeah.
The kind of any pick you're kind of thinking about is going to struggle versus Shadow Demon.
It's really just about the game plan that DC wants to go by.
So, yeah, the we Void, might need to address the Mirana too.
Yeah. Void Mirana.
Void Mirana sounds
pretty safe. Sounds pretty DC.
That's been one of Wii's most successful heroes, I'd say. At least over the last month or so when they've been struggling. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree with what you guys were saying that kind of solidifying Wii's hero pool is a big issue that they face. I really like, you know, anytime you talk about Digital Chaos and their pluses, their upsides, I really like Resolution as a player. I think that no matter what hero you're going to put him on, he's going to find a way to do something good in the game. Moo also, really wide hero pool, capable of playing that Timbersaw, that Slaughter in the offlane position. But
I actually think Resolution was a better mid than a carry.
I don't know. I like his stability. And there's the Void open, as we suggested. Expect to see the Mirana, maybe the Phoenix.
I think he was at least maybe a little better, but like with this team, whether it's Wii or Resolution, who do you want mid carry? I'd rather have Resolution carry though, based on like this roster at least.
Agreed.
But... And Wii's hero pool. That was the thing where you go back to like the Secret days with Wii, and like part of the reason which probably led to him being removed from the team is this team succeeded when he had, like, they could play around his comfort picks. The Nanying, when they won that tournament, it was like the Wind Ranger. Then later it was the Invoker when you look at the Shanghai Majors. So they found heroes that worked for him.
Misery definitely had fun playing Ogre yesterday.
he
picks it again.
Yeah, I really do.
Ogre.
I feel like it's got a lot of value, especially on Dire, that, you know, we all know Dire really wants to contest. This has been since TI5 last year. Really wants to contest that bottom right corner of the map. Really wants to get those Radiant tier 1 and tier mid and bottom tier 1 towers, secure the access to the Roche Pit. Ogre, a hero that really helps you in those that aggressive early game.
Yeah, with the newest buff to Bloodlust, you actually, like, having your, at level 2, having Ignite and Bloodlust, you're pretty threatening running around the map.
Let's see what Seeker want to do. This is either probably a full position or offlane hero. Yeah. They historically have almost always been saving our TZ Envy heroes for late in the draft, exception being, like, when you're getting something like a Drow Ranger, but there's enough Shadow Demon partners, you're not, like, pressured to pick one too early on.
And they will. Wow. They're going to go for it anyway.
Okay. And again, yet another hero that Fnatic helped bring this hero to the fore at Manila as well. But Secret have been experimenting with TB for quite some time. And again, you abuse the disruption illusions with that long duration.
Yeah, I mean, Envy loves the hero.
Yep.
Yeah, just a specific person for it. I mean, him sitting there before talking about Terrorblade, he was just like, I wouldn't do that. That's not what would happen if I was playing Terrorblade.
Oh, I would, yeah. My favorite was I would never lose that lane.
I would never lose that lane.
Just Jackie things.
Yeah. DC bans out the Ursa, so like we were mentioning, Secret did change it up a bit yesterday by picking that and putting it mid.
I really like that, that they showed in kind of both of the games, but I really like that they put one of, they put Artesia on a hero that kills heroes, they put Envy on a hero that kills towers.
Yeah. It's cute.
Cute.
Yeah, it was.
Now the Timbersaw ban I really like. I think that obviously can clear through those Terrorblade illusions very easily.
Yep.
Can drop that Chakram right on top of the disruption target to decrease the value of that save.
What else have we seen that's good versus Terrorblade? Like Terrorblade was super popular, then he stopped getting picked, and now he's like kind of back.
OG did like the Legion Coddle dual lane that really messed with it. We just saw that Terrorblade get run over by that. The Sand King Chen. I mean, Sand King overall pretty decent for
this. There's been a few games where I've seen Sand King Rick Terrorblade. Oh. Like the offlane Sand King with Caustic just.
Yeah. Sand King just destroys anything that's illusion based if he gets the right amount of farm. But I think it's more the fact that Metamorphosis now does not persist after Aegis or after you die is a very big deal for Terrorblade. It means he has to play a lot more carefully.
DC banning out the Beastmaster, obviously Bulba's hero. It's one of his favorite.
I think it's best. It's his best hero
right now too.
So. Darkseer he plays pretty well, but
banned out.
Beastmaster, I would agree with that.
Darkseer, I feel like he plays really well, but they play or it's like a duel. It's not even just him playing the Darkseer. It's like two people playing it in a way whenever they play it.
I'm still waiting to see Puppy go back to his junglers. I mean, we're seeing that these like Na'Vi are showing that Chen Enchantress. These picks work amazingly well. You can play aggressive, and if you talk about you guys mentioning like Puppy and Bulba like being the space creators roaming around together.
Band, by the way,
yeah, pull out a Chen, pull an Enchantress for Puppy. Like to me, those are heroes that could suit really well for this Team Secret.
And he. No, Puppy's actually the one that plays very similar to art style. Like they used to play together, and they basically always take the first creep and just make the move right away.
Mm-hmm. Okay, there's the Mirana.
The Mirana, as we mentioned. Well,
Chen Enchantress not quite as good anymore, but
yeah.
I think you might pick a Tide here for Bulba. I kind of want to secure that offlane position.
That is like the most prominent that they pick, and it's.
Is that good versus Void Mirana though?
It's not great, but.
I actually kind of like Doom as Puppy's hero versus the Void. I remember him, he picked it like a lot of the time versus the Tidehunter. And I think that he can really neutralize the Void threat this game.
Yeah, it's interesting. It's like a similar kind of thing, like Doom the Void, Doom the Tide.
Yeah.
Get rid of that big team fight control.
What else is there?
He's played a bit of Axe. That was the qualifiers. A lot of four position Axe for Puppy.
More so with the Darkseer though, but yeah, he did play it. A lot to say.
I think it was his most played hero during those the European qualifiers.
He was pretty much topping net worth a lot of those games when he was playing the
Ops. That was crazy.
So, I mean, other than that, you can. I don't think you're in any rush to pick up a mid laner, but you're expecting DC to run the Weeha mid Mirana, so.
Yeah, it's been interesting. Last night, I remember the Secret versus Call drafts were like super quick. It was like speed drafting. Secret taking their time with this one.
What else does Arteezy want? Something that kind of tempo controls. Because I think they've been doing that a little bit for him. Okay, well they're gonna they're gonna take the Coddle themselves.
Coddle versus Void, very good. That's where we actually were initially seeing a lot of Coddle in during the summit was. Just mana leak in the Void, and he gets forced to just chew through that mana pool really quickly.
Mana leak it, as well as Blinding Light in the Necromancer.
And, I mean, Chakra with Terrorblade, and just being able to bring illusion heroes all over the map, you can just super accelerate his farm. Obviously, faster illusion creation from Chakra as well. Super beneficial for him.
So they do Secret do the Slardar pick now, where you can Chakra and get two crushes off? Oh, you can't move.
You don't like Slardar? They need some like just reliable stun. Like Tide is good for team fight, but right now your only stun is disruption. That's not really a stun. Like if you've picked Tide, you're only fighting around the Ravage.
I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm not a fan of Radiant side Slardar in general, but it might fit here.
I'm trying to think what else. Earthshaker.
For whom?
Secret? It's for Secret. Yeah, I don't know. I was just trying to think of.
I mean, they could get something like a Puck or something out of the mid lane as well, but I'm, again, not a huge fan of the Puck. Dragon Knight. That's some kind of reliable disable, but.
So for DC, do we think that I'm kind of leaning toward Void being a safe laner actually right now?
Do we see that Coddle? You definitely can.
I think they still need a little bit more to clear illusions. Mirana's
Phoenix,
good,
maybe?
But.
Phoenix, you said?
Yeah.
Phoenix, okay.
A little bit.
Yeah, resolution Slark, that's been something that they've shown a lot lately.
Slark gets, I mean, Slark gets hurt by Caudle pretty hard as well.
Yeah, Caudle and Terrorblade's not too scared of Slark.
A Dark Pact takes off Monolith, doesn't it?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, so that's not necessarily a hard counter. Secret here. Yeah.
Still can be annoying early on. Caudle, lots of damage versus a squishy Slark.
Gotta believe they're gonna come back with their offlaner.
I mean, for Secret, they haven't got anything obvious that benefits from the chakra right now.
Yeah, there is a slaughter. I thought they were gonna.
Very nice call.
I think last pick for Secret, some kind of follow-up damage burst for the slider, because right now it's like slider blinks in crushes. Like, I mean, TB can metamorph, but he has to walk on in, so they need some kind of follow-up from Arteezy's role.
Yeah, that's
an alchemist.
Worried
about like just a slow-paced farm game from Secret.
I'm trying to think what hero it could be for Arteezy. Windrunner? I mean, but that's weird, and I don't really know how I feel about it. I don't really like it.
You could still maybe DP.
Yeah, you could still DP.
You got enough push though with TB.
Ben Wyvern.
Yeah, so I feel like this is, again, the model for them has been Envy on a, one of Envy and R2 are on a hero that pushes and another on a hero that fights.
That fights, yeah.
Was it Wyvern a weird pick? Why did they ban Wyvern?
The illusion clear, Witch's Curse against TB.
Because DC has no outspam, and that's one of Sox's big heroes that he likes to play, right. So I guess that would be like the only reason I would really see it as.
I like DK as a pick, it just doesn't strike me as like a secret hero, but there's a secret / Arteezy hero, so I guess Storm.
We felt like in the previous series when EG picked Storm in game one that it was a little bit telegraphed, certainly not so here.
Definitely not, and you said, hey, hero killer and tower hitter.
I mean, it fits, and with the Caudle too. That's one of the big issues, right? You talked to Blitz about Storm, and one of the big issues is that after the nerf to his ulti, it feels like certain points in the mid game that he's like an item behind.
Yeah,
with his mono regen, so you need a hero that's going to kind of make up for that, and Caudle certainly fits the bill.
Well, DC last pick needs probably lockdown or safe for the Slark against Storm, maybe. Lion, there you go.
Okay. Definitely the safest pick. Yeah. Great Illusion Clearer, great versus Storm Spirit. That's a really good line pickup at the end there.
Yeah. I think this is a really even draft. I think both these teams have pretty clear win conditions. I like Secret's lineup, but DC has the tools to deal with it. Fogda, final thoughts here. Who do you see taking the 1-0 advantage?
I really like the Caudle pick. I think it's one of these heroes that can just do so much if it's played properly. We saw Innocence playing it, so I like Secret's lineup. I also think that they don't really have too much synergy with the Void Chronosphere. So I think it's going to like hurt them a bit. So I'm going to go for Secret in this game.
Yeah, I just am curious to see how Secret will lane this. I'm a little bit leery because we saw the Storm really kind of peter out in the last series. But I think they didn't telegraph it nearly so much. I think this is really, really even. I'm going to lean toward DC in game one. And with that, let's hand it over to Gods and Merlini for the cast.
Well, thank you guys on the other couch. Ben Wu here with me, Gods. We've got game one, Secret versus DC. Talk about it as a potential grudge match, but really it just feels like these teams looking forward to TI, looking forward to hopefully getting a tournament win here at StarLadder iLeague. Fairly even on the drafts over there. What do you think about these two drafts now that we see the end result?
I slightly favor Secret of the 10 heroes. I think Slark is the odd man out.
Yeah.
To me, like, I really don't see his role fitting in this game. No synergy with the Chronosphere. He's not particularly good versus any of Secret's heroes. Like, maybe he like dispels Mana Leak with Dark Pact, but like it's very minor in the grand scheme of things. I think he might struggle a lot.
Do you like the Storm last pick as far as Secret's draft goes?
I always like it with Keeper of the Light or Drow Ranger. I think like Storm seems to really need one of those two heroes to shine in the mid game.
Yeah.
Or otherwise he's just too much downtime.
I mean, earlier on it just felt like they picked Caudle because like, oh, we got this Caudle pick. It's gonna be great. And then you see it. Nothing to really shaker, but now, hey, Storm Spirit's there. It's gonna be a much more clear partner for it. One of the great things I like about Storm with the Caudle is you can actually ball and use all your mana, TP home, and then you're immediately recalled back in as well. So it's not just for the shaker, for the mana with the hero.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll see what DC can do.
Vortex plus Mana Leak.
The synergy.
Oh.
It's also the Shadow Demon Keeper Light is a really old school tri lane. It used to be one of the most contested, I think, in like 6.78 maybe. That like Disruption Soulcatcher into Blast is really strong, and maybe you can even give a Faceless Void before he gets his time walk off.
Do you think Secret can even help the offlane for Bulbous Slaughter, or are they just happy to kind of sack him? Iron Talon.
I think
you try and do that, then you just immediately regret and be like, man, should have gone Iron Talon.
But Bulba doesn't seem like he has been Iron Taloning that much.
Yeah,
though.
I mean, it's like very weak laning stage if he's contested, so definitely a lane. Shadow Demon Coddle could complete. To me, Shadow Demon Coddle aggro trialing can destroy a Slack.
Yeah, I think you actually stay up there at the start, though, to make sure that the Ogre can't do Ogre things, just because I think they can easily set up on the Storm Spirit with like a Fire Blast into like a Elite Double Starfall. I think that the Storm Spirit is very vulnerable in this particular draft.
All right, well, looks like we're going to get ourselves into game number one. DC are ready to go after a quick pause. As we'll hop ourselves into the game, there is Jackie Mao playing the Terrorblade, one of his signature heroes. Poor Man Shield and Tengos up against the Faceless Void. Perhaps signaling that he's maybe not going to get as much help as you typically see, that he's gone for this first item, Poor Man Shield. He'll be expecting that Faceless Void matchup. And
I think he expects the Ogre to come down there.
Gotcha.
The Ogre is just very annoying.
How important is this Ogre as far as roaming around? And,
oh, well, puppy.
Puppy.
There is no way he's getting out of this one.
Yep, arrow even lands and Puppy is done for. We getting the kill and everything. Now it's a game of find the Observer Ward, and it looks like, oh, they'll get it barely with the Sentry in range. Oh boy. Did we even get that last hit on the Observer Ward? He's got like First Blood. Yeah, he got the last hit. He's got the last hit. He got Observer Ward, First Blood. Now he's going to get Bounty Rune. Dream start from Mirana, you could say.
And now the Sea Slaughter does not have a Quelling Blade, so they don't even need to really contest this pool too much. So here's how Misery's gonna respond to this. He has a TP scroll already on TC. That's actually a little strange. Was that pool to him too?
Storm TP level 1.
Yeah. No, he just bought himself. Why? Why does he get TP level 1?
He's 9k MMR. You can't question him.
I'm actually trying to figure out why. I'm not questioning him. I'm trying to understand him. It's just not something you see very often.
Oh! Is that
wow.
50 gold investment for... Oh, and he misses the play block, though! Oh! Well, 50 gold down the drain.
He got the bounty rune, though. Okay, yeah. Well, there we have our reasoning.
So... The idea is, yeah, so you can get the better body block mid. Because Coddle wanted to be up top as soon as possible, I guess. Mm-hmm. Puppy's like, look, I ain't blocking your wave mid.
That's some next level stuff right there.
All right.
Good idea. Not the best execution, but still very, very cool.
Yep. So Ogre's starting up top for now, perhaps recognizing the presence of Puppy in this lane.
Oh, did they miss the D ward too on their farm camp? What a nice stun.
This is going to be a rough start for Puppy. They hit the bounce and everything. Puppy gives up a second kill to Digital Chaos here. Resolution should be okay here. Another stun to follow up could come from Saxu. There's an Impale. Misery throws out another Ignite. Could this be a second kill? Bulba's very tanky. Has the Fairy Fire as well. Will pop it. And Misery, perhaps in over his head, very tanky as the Ogre Magi. Shouldn't be going down. And with Puppy's return, lane does stabilize a bit. But a couple of kills. And a salve on the Slaughter forced out here in the top lane.
An Ogre Magi, very low on mana at this point too. Even though Puppy has died two times, I don't think the Ogre can do too much more damage in the early game, especially if Slaughter had to salve up himself. And yeah, I think they actually should be okay, but that is a lot of ground to concede in the early game. But more importantly, I think Storm's having a good time in the mid, not the easiest matchup. And if the Shadow Demon is constantly on bottom lane, you need to make sure that he has a good time.
I guess, I mean, Mirana never really known for last-hitting capabilities in this mid lane, but has
but
got...
way more kill potential.
Yeah, and has Bottle coming out very early, thanks to all the early kills, Bounty Runes, Observer Wards.
Bottle and Boots. Why not? Jeez.
That's where TZ does its play very cautiously, but bottom lane, Metamorph was used early, so they don't have the best kill potential. Another 50 seconds I'll have to wait, but this is just about zoning Mu as much as possible. Shadow Demon, not much mana to play around with, but just trying to get Mu out of this lane as much as possible, and we'll see a salve and 9 stick charges, so Mu at least able to get pretty much somewhat uncontested XP out of this lane.
Yeah, that first blood actually caused them on too, because they lost control of their pool camp. I think like Puppy would ideally be able to stack up a little bit for the storm.
Yeah, and they missed the D ward with that sentry too. So
that observer ward doesn't block though, does it?
No,
it's a little far out. Yeah,
it's just a scouting. So I guess they want to know when that camp is being farmed somewhat. But Misery just happy to see this top lane. Do you like the decision, just camp this Ogre top? He doesn't have much mana anymore, like what's the game plan here?
I think if it's just two people, I think the Slark has a really difficult time farming with infinite Illuminate spam.
Yeah, so we kind of theorycrafted potential tri-lane, but just the dual lane alone has let Resolution sit on just 7 creep kills. He's now hit his 8th, he's tied with the Slaughter, so it's not going to be an easy lane for him to farm. And meanwhile, Envy, free farming away, top of the CS charts with the Storm Spirit, so laning state looking very good for Team Secret. And that's like you give up those kills and it hasn't really influenced DC. Like they had to commit so many resources to get the kill, particularly on Puppy when they used multiple ignites, multiple impales, and suddenly your two supports have no mana for the defensive tri lane. You can't really zone heroes out.
Oh, and with the early Moondrops pickup, that's going to make the double stun combo very difficult to execute onto him. And looks like Misery trying to figure out where he wants to go right now. Just been sitting base for quite some time. And looks like he will TP mid.
Smoke gank attempt on mid, perhaps. Has picked up some raindrops of his own.
Yeah, through the raindrops, though, I'm not sure if it's possible.
They need to hit that long duration arrow, I guess.
Maybe, but if he gets a good rune. It's a haste rune, so.
Leaves top a bit vulnerable here, but Saxka weaves his way through back to his tower, and Misery now has to make a decision. What's the easy kill looks to be top with the raindrops on Arteezy. Misery at least seems torn. Do I go top? Do I go mid?
He's been missing forever, though. It's not like a support that just sits there and pulls, so you know he's either ganking mid or top.
Does Arteezy know if he goes in for a remnant, he could pay the price? And Misery hugging the side of the trees. There's going to be a fire blast followed up by a star storm. He's already broken the raindrops. Arteezy doesn't get hit by the double star storm, though. The arrow will be enough. Coddle blast doesn't get any return kills. So nice pickup by DC. Successful smoke gank.
Mm-hmm. Nice and patient by them. Thinking maybe you thought the raindrops would save my You used, what, 3 charges right there? Not value.
On the storm? Oh, wow. Yeah, very early on. And I guess just being able to break it and put it on cooldown with the fire blast meant that you get the full damage from the star storm.
Mm-hmm.
But, and the other thing is, you're using that Ogre level 2. Often it's Ogre level 2 with Bloodlust, so perhaps caught a little bit out by that one. Bulba at top, though. He's been surrounded by 3. There will be a pounce to land. Waiting perhaps to stun. Nicely played so he doesn't get caught by the Dark Pact. And Bulba is going to look to create a lot of space here and probably just go for a deny on a neutral camp. He's level 4 and will find himself some mean wolves to end his life on. So, nice deny. Doesn't lose too much in the way of gold.
How's Pi doing in terms of levels?
It's got 10 CS. Oh, level 5 almost. Okay. And this is the beauty of the dual lane setup. When you can run dual lanes and have and CS well in all your lanes, you're going to have very high level supports typically. Perhaps less so in the off lane with the Coddle, but the safe lane with the pulls and the stacks is going really well.
I'm not sure if they've gotten enough out of the Ogre in this early game to justify letting the Shadow Demon have his way on the bottom. Like, just being able to constantly farm those. I don't think he's been able to stack, but still, being level 5, 6 minutes in as a support is very, very nice.
Oh yeah, Paiza, very happy camp out. TZ.
Where? You took my room, bro.
Yeah, I was about to say that. that would get a report if it was a pub game.
Well, he'll
perhaps just go for some bulk. He's full HP, he's full man. He's fine. I'm sure Pi's telling him, like, come on, man, I gotta get my fast arcanes up. Arrow coming in from bottom lane. Doesn't land on Bulba, and now he knows exactly where Wii is. Just fishing around for that one. Needed to hit the arrow to initiate, it looks like.
I'm surprised they didn't pull in the Ogre for this and try and do the gank in the T1, but maybe just getting a little bit impatient or wanting to farm out that mid lane. However, the Lion is already soaking up the mid XP, so I'm surprised that he went for that low percentage play.
Because of the tri-lane top, Saxka not even close to his level 6, which could be a pretty important tool as far as being able to find kills on Terrorblade or Storm. Without the Finger of Death, they don't have the best burst damage to take out some of these cores.
You can tell that the Ogre and the Lion, they want to move around, they want to get kills. They're like in position and, you know, they're not really like stacking or pulling too much. They're a little bit behind levels. Like if they get one kill right now and then get another kill once they get a Tome or level 6, then they'll be in a pretty good spot. But like right now they're
not getting enough accomplished.
That was a really nice pounce setup. There will be defensive disruption from Pi. Resolution fairly low here, but he's level 7, so he's actually been given a lot of kind of solo XP, it looks like, despite the support spending some time up in this top lane, so...
If they wait too long, the Storm will be able to TP and kill them. Is that Sentry Ward too far out to see that?
Okay. It sees it, yeah. It's just a matter of getting up there without paying for it with your life and...
Get the value Tango. I don't think any of them have Tangos anymore.
So just by the kill score, it feels like, if anything, Secret's leading right now.
Yeah, I think they're still getting a decent amount.
Oh, well, they're leading on XP, not on farm, but we'll see what the plan's gonna be. Pi, perhaps a Fortune Haster, although it was just a lion in the neighborhood, so he'll get away from there just fine.
I think their lineup was supposed to struggle a lot more in the early game, considering the first early two kills on Puppy. Yep. But they're able to, like, get really good farm out of the map. Envy is doing a lot of damage to his T1, whereas Resolution still kind of be a big fishy.
They're going to TP to try and defend this one. Time Walk off to start, just to get rid of that Illuminate damage, and Pi, perhaps considering an
offensive the double
disruption.
Shadow Poison!
Have mercy, please.
That hurts. This early on, you got level 3 Shadow Poison.
It's actually not bad with if you get like a Disruption, you get like 2 guaranteed poisons right there.
4 or 5 Shadow Poison stacks with a Soul Catcher, that's a good 500-600 damage right there. That's probably more damage than the Finger of Death. Well, if you can get a little more like around level 7, level 3, it's close to like that amount of damage.
I think later you can have like a ridiculous stream of illusions too. Yeah. And just chain chakra with disruption on Terrorblade, and with Terrorblade illusions and Manta, you can have like 7 illusions maybe.
Well,
maybe not that many.
It's a tower, it's farm across the board. You've got 4 heroes sitting on 28 CS or higher. Even your 5 position Pi is on 14 CS, so.
Yeah. They need to get a kill with a Void. You'll see sometimes like the supports will move into the Void lane once he gets level 6 and then just like chrono into whatever setup you have. But I don't think they're doing a great job of getting Mu involved too much early, probably because of the threat in their safe lane.
It's kind of like a chrono into what, perhaps with the Mirana,
Arrow.
I can see it.
Arrow,
yeah.
Easily.
But that requires 2 cores to get involved. Ideally, like, you talk about supports rotating, or like a Lion Ogre with Void, doesn't necessarily guarantee you kills here.
I think they need to get the Lion 6, though. I think if he sits mid, though, he could potentially die to the Storm Spirit.
He's about to hit level 5, and in the 10-minute mark, he can buy the Tomb, so that should be really the game plan for DC. Get a level 6, smoke up even. Nice kill at top, though. That'll help Zaxxas road to level 6.
Yeah, very nice. Very necessary for them too. I think Secret are just going to be content to power farm their jungle and wait for Bloodstone, wait for Terrorblade to get a little bit stronger with Manta plus some other items. And looks like Misery looking to interrupt that already with the Observer Ward place just a couple minutes ago. And hey, Artesian, how's it going?
I mean, not much he can do to get this kill on his own. If anything, Misery could be in some trouble. Artesi playing fairly conservative, not looking to commit too far forward until he's sure Misery can go down, and does manage to find that kill. Bulba rotating in to be safe as well. That was 5 heroes from Secret, but doesn't really feel like they overcommitted too many resources. If anything, they just immediately farm off of that kill, so...
That was a strange move by Ogre. Like, maybe if he were smoked up, and then he can, like, kind of get vision and place a ward if he wants to, but that was...
Or you gotta use that buddy system. He was there alone.
Yeah.
Like, if he was there with, like, a buddy or two, it's like, okay, well, kind of see where he can find a kill off of this. Bulba. Ooh, times to stun does hit Wii, although the leak goes off at the same time with the Metamorphosis damage. Wii is slow, amped up, but we'll get away. So... Won't be a kill. Terrorblade, no points in reflection there. Maybe a slow from the reflection could have helped him out, but...
Yeah, he's notorious for not going points in reflection, though.
Yeah.
DE.
I remember he used to go for the 044 build with no Sunder. It was like the mind game where it's like, oh, I don't actually have... I have Sunder, guys. Like, don't try and gank me, I'll Sunder you, but... No, he just had images and Metamorph.
And then you see +2, +2, +2. And then you're like, okay, we know what's up. Sunder, that was before Sunder got buffed, too, that... yeah, it was definitely.
Well, you can actually check if they leveled up by hovering over the icon as well, because it shows the cast range of spells. You can see when enemies have leveled up. Like if you see like a Sand King level 1, you can see if he's leveled up Burrow Strike by hovering over the spell.
That should not be.
I kind of agree, but that's Dota 2 things. It only shows the cast range of the spell if they've actually leveled it up, I believe. Fog was nodding at me. I think. I believe that's the case. I don't know. Maybe I'm just spewing nonsense. But they're looking for the Void here. Mu has a time walk in a couple of seconds. We'll get to the lowdown. Arteezy's Arcane Rune. Almost helping him get that kill.
He almost sprung an ice trap too. He had the observer ward and he tried to drop a couple of remnants behind the tree line to pop him.
So it's, they get the line 6, but it seems at the same time they're going to have the Shadow Blade on Slug. So we talked about being able to play faster pace. It's going to happen with the Shadow Blade, line level 6. You can get the Void Chrono involved now.
Slaughter needs a place to farm his Blink Dagger. He went Tranquils. Or did he go Tranquils? He went Treads? Wow, he's actually very far away.
He had Treads in like 800 gold and looks like he then bought a wand, bought some RDs.
Okay. Well, I...
He's in no rush to get his Blink at least.
Yeah, they can't put out any pressure though. Like the Storm Spirit is still very weak. He can easily die to a Lion Hex or just get solo chronoed. It's totally worth it for him at this point. And then it's going to be a while until he gets his Bloodstone and then maybe an Orchid later for the Faceless Void or something like that. But it's like, aside from that, who else is going to be making the moves? Caudill can't really initiate. Shadow Demon, I don't really think, wants to put himself in that sort of position.
Are you worried for Secret then? Because the DC have all their items. They're about to hit the Axe.
Yeah, I'm worried for them right now because, like, I just don't see them being able to make any maneuvers. All they're going to be doing is like farming up their jungle and trying to defend against the stacks. And then DC, like, they could easily just expend solo chronos on cores and I think get a lot out of it, unless Shadow Demon's there. But I think now's the time for DC to increase that choke.
Ooh. For that courier, burst away. Also hasn't scattered out the Shadow Blade on the Slack yet. It just got delivered after that little courier find. So he's gonna, drawing lines towards the mid lane, perhaps thinking about a backstab here. Sentry Ward already in place. So if a creep wave comes by, he will be spotted, but he doesn't get caught by that one. Meanwhile, it's mid lane, Terra Blade taking out the Ogre Magi, who just looked to be a little overextended with the T1 tower going down as well.
We still have yet to see a chrono from Mu. And Mu actually does it sometimes where he's just like not terribly interested and leaving the lane.
It's
but...
a question of whether it's him or maybe his team. Like the Lion's just saying, look, I'm going to farm my 6. Miranda's saying, I want to farm my Axe. So it may not even be a personal decision, but the team.
But I think that's one of the strengths of Void. You can, like, getting that early chrono is guaranteed kill. You can tell, like, Resolution, he wants to get kills. He was scouting out mid. He was scouting out bottom now and just not really any opportunity for him. They will see the Illuminate, so maybe
he's
they'll go for
he's
the kill.
His way through the trees, maybe?
Yeah.
He snuck his way through. That's a really nice play.
Oh, hello.
He got in behind the tower without being detected, thanks to that little Quelling Blade on through. That's really nice. Haven't seen a play like that in a while. Stacks at top gets balled in on, has the finger, gonna look to turn and kill Arteezy, but Arteezy still has mana to play around with. Gets low, has he got a TP? No, he doesn't, can't get out of this one, has Soaring and, no, he doesn't have Soaring, has Arcane Boots. Can he ball away? Doesn't look like it, one or two more right clicks. Wii is looking for this, Resolution is as well, we'll bounce on over and Mirana gets the kill. DC also getting a T1 tower at bottom potentially.
Very nice quick hex from the Lion there.
Well, move. I'm going to happily get a T1. I haven't seen... I mean, 0-0-0. You said it. No Chronospheres, but DC, despite that, are in a really nice position here. Can they kill Envy? With the Sunder there, not an easy kill.
They do see a big stack.
Mm-hmm. Dark Pack already used and pounce his way out. Has just enough mana for the ultimate, and he'll commit that.
So they see that stack, and they don't actually have good heroes to take out the stack at all. Sardar, maybe you can like amp up the big ones.
Terrorblade with Metamorph is decent.
It's not great.
Yeah, it
is. I don't really think you want to use meta to farm mansions, especially with the type of pace.
It's kind of like Secret's playing a farm game. Like they haven't got the Sardar Blink, I guess, so it's... Maybe TB's meant to be the one creating space. Go push some towers,
he
TB
was. That's what he did in the mid lane.
Yeah.
And I think that worked out really well for them, and that he bought his team a little bit of time, but like Mirana is top on the net worth, so she should have her eggs like fairly soon. They have the Vlads up on Faceless Void, so they can do Roche pretty soon too. Like I think at some point Secret is going to have to leave their side of the map, especially if this mid T1 falls.
And
this is going to be it.
I feel like
setting up for smoke.
Mirana with the eggs is pretty decent against TB anyway.
Yeah, it's amazing. I think they drafted very good heroes that are anti-TB and anti-Storm, the Lion pick in particular, I think very good versus both of them.
Okay.
So he will use meta for it, and Rezo scouted out the stacks earlier, and his team has to know that they're trying to do that. Storm Spirit in a little bit of trouble over here, but they are not interested in killing him.
Oh, that TP in. Rezo is going for Puppy instead, ignores the TPs. There's a chrono, he's holding on to it a long time. Will we see our first chrono here, Mu?
Can he go for it now? Still looking to go in the back foot, holding onto it for a long time. He's stunned up for now. Now he goes in, hits two with it. Patience pays off as Misery gets the Fire Blast on both on two as well. Arteezy stunned up. The stun from Bulba's nice. It catches him just in time onto three heroes to help Arteezy escape Resolution.
No, my Blink Dagger!
So oh, close yet so far.
So close.
DC just steamrolling over them. They're so strong right now.
This is what they tried to do in one of the games that we saw yesterday. It's just like have Puppy stall. And DC, like, they read that completely. Like, they had Keeper like, okay, you defend the mid lane. We're all going to farm. And then they're just like, okay, we'll just jump Keeper. And then everyone else is going to fall like flies because you have no wave clear anymore. And we're just going to swarm you. So now that that T1 tower has fallen, I think DC have, like, really good control of this game right now. They have a lot of ways to solo kill people. I think the Marana's really strong. Faces Void, maybe not strong enough to solo kill people. I think Stark definitely is, especially the Keeper. I think Keeper is particularly vulnerable, but he has a lot of items, actually.
Yeah. Feels like some of the same problems with the Secret at Middle Mage, where it's like no one's there to create space. You've got Arteezy and Envy both looking to farm, and it's not that Bulba's like not trying to create space. He's slaughtered with no blink. And if he has a blink, he has no ganking partner. So
he also has nowhere to farm his Blink Dagger. Yeah. I think that's like a much bigger issue because TB was farming like the right camps and then the Storm Spear is farming like the mid camps. So there's just like not enough creeps on the map for them. And how is Wii? I haven't seen him Blink in a while. So yeah, he's very farmed.
Oh yeah. I mean, he's out farming the Terrorblade, he's farming big ancient stacks, and TB's only been prioritizing his farm, pushing a tower here. He's taken two towers, like two towers, ancient stacks, and still out farmed by Mirana. Yeah. So, look for this Mirana to make an impact on this game. He's been fantastic so far as DC. One of the perhaps downsides of their draft is that they don't have the best Roche taking lineup. That's something which, and they can do it slowly, but it's not going to be all that easy.
I just think it's super predictable where they're going to be, because they've just been huddling in their jungle for a very long time. And, Dire, you scan, it checked out, so they know that they're sitting behind Bulba, and Bulba's still trying to get his Blink Dagger, and Mu in a little bit of trouble, but turns around and hits three.
And Arteezy Quinn, this is Bulba, the two hero impale. Saxka gets set up for the slam dunk from Mu. Three dead immediately. Puppy trying to TP. Is there a stun? Where's the bash? Moo! He says, come on, guys. OS Frog, please.
Oh, that should be fairly easy rush for them.
He's actually max time dilation over the time lock, so I guess perhaps making sense he doesn't get a bash there.
Yeah, he was in the... He's like in the defensive position. I think the one-on-one situation, you go for like the 2-0-3 build, but for this, it's, like he's trying to help out his team a lot, and... Yep, Secret. Uh-huh.
You can't. We talked about they're not great at Roche, but it's pretty easy to Roche with three enemy heroes dead. Even if
that's why they got the Bloods. If they have the Bloods, it's like pretty straightforward and simple. But like Secret cannot afford to give away a big fight like that.
They set up that corner. Like, they really were trying to force the issue on Mu there.
But the scan, the preparation from DC, they knew exactly what they're going to do. Like they can't make moves with just one hero. Like Storm can't solo kill anyone at this point in the game. The Ogre has raindrops, he's like the least farmed hero on the map, but he's still like, or Moondrops, he had Moondrops, but he's still like very tanky at the time, and Lion will just turn around and hex him instantly, he doesn't have Max Vortex, so I'm like very worried about Secret like still going for like, what about the Blink Dagger, is it coming anytime soon?
Yeah, and that's, if anything, that's going to be more important than getting farm on either TB or Storm right now, just because... They can't really find kills or make plays, like you say with that, unless they bring five, so...
But now, as Star jumps in, he's just gonna die. Like, you get double Starfall with Sprint on. Hopefully you don't have Sprint on, but even without it, like, you're gonna get crushed. So we see Vale with the Lion, the Mirana, the Ogre.
What is the play for Secret? Is there much they can do, or is it just...
Oh, help TB gets really big. Wait for Storm to get Orchid plus Bloodstone. And
so just like defend high ground, kind of wait it out till you're farmed enough.
You can get BKBs too later. Yeah. I don't even know if you want BKBs. I'll probably just rely on Shadow Demon for them to get saved during the Chronosphere. But I also think like once they have the Keeper Ags, I think they can pick and choose their fights a lot better. But I think the problem with that is you still might have a Slark on you, and I don't think Keeper's strong enough to hold the gem right now.
We talked about how maybe it's not the best Slark game, but it's. It doesn't even matter. Resolution doesn't have to do all the damage because Wii's having a great game. Moose hit some good chronos now, even though he didn't really use it all that much in the early game. So
yeah, they got a lot of out of their safe lane. Couple kills on Puppy, and kill on Bulba.
Well,
Puppy close to the egg scepter. That's where, I mean, Secret can play the split push game.
Recall, Storm Zip, Terrorblade Illusions, Shadow Demon Illusions. They have a lot of ways to threaten lanes and be elusive, but still, they're not going to win the farm war. And
it was funny because I first saw them around the Boots of Travel. I'm like, huh, like Boots of Travel this early on, is that really nice? But I'm like, he knows Secret are going to start split pushing.
Oh,
like,
Puppy.
If you're versing this Secret team and they're playing from behind, they will always split push. So we is like,
yeah, he
preparing.
Knows.
He's like,
I was on this team before. Yeah. I know what happens.
This is
don't fight, guys. Don't fight.
Puppy and Envy are just like telling each other, like, yeah, yeah. Avoid fights. Split up the map.
They're probably saying that before the game.
We probably had Boots. He changed his TP on the auto buy to Boots of Travel or something.
I actually think they should have given the Aegis to Slark with the way that he's playing. Like, he's the one that's always up in front. Did Mirana get the Aegis?
Yeah, Mirana.
Yeah. Like, Mirana's the one that's like farming all the time. She's not really been in a position of danger. She's just there to clean up.
Close on the arrow there. If he hits that with a 5 second, should get the kill with the double Star Storm.
I think if they give Slark the Aegis, like, he can just go in the Keeper, and they might just disrupt him, but if they commit enough resources to kill the Slark, I think everyone else is just gonna come in and die. Like, right now, Rezzo is, like, not completely sure whether or not he wants to initiate. He's trying to scout out for the jumpers in the back, but he can't really play as aggressively as it demands without a BKB.
Yeah, and he was kind of ignoring the Storm. No, you can't kill a Storm in Slark.
Nope,
I need didn't find anyone else.
How's Lion's items?
He's Blink. He had Blink in the last fight or two. Since then, just wards, I guess.
He's fine. He's doing well.
I mean, all you really need is your Blink for the most part. Anything else beyond that's luxury. So, 3.5k on Rezzo. Any items that kind of stand out? Just upgrade your Shadow Blade, Scotty, Basher. What do you reckon here?
Well, Mu didn't really go farming items. He went for the Blink, which I think is nice because they need to be able to catch out these supports. And Puppy is surprisingly tanky. Yeah, no items really look that strange.
Okay. So TB Illusions going to be the perhaps bane of for DC moving forward, but
they already have Lion.
Yeah, exactly. You have Lion. They have ways of putting him out. It's just maybe going to be applying pressure to all lanes, but yeah, there we go. DC take a tier 2.
So now that most of the tier 2s are down, 2 out of 3, I think like Secret just need to concentrate on keeping the net worth like even around 7,500 to 10,000. I think that's kind of the difference that you're looking for. You don't have as much control of the map, but you have way better heroes to split pushing out the lanes. Although I say that, but DC have a Mirana on the opposite team, who is one of the best like wave clearers.
Yeah, and with the Boots Travel can kind of be anywhere on the map. Let's get caught out here. We nice to repel. Sax gets ready for it. They blow a Bulba to start things off. Our TZ hexed up. Is there gonna be another Star Storm soon? That Aghanim Scepter doesn't proc.
Oh my goodness.
Mu with the predictive plays. Have they got the damage for this? They need a Blink follow-up from Weehaw on the Mirana, but he's a bit low. Another two hero pale Saxka! How good is this Lion play as Envy getting chased down as well? Starstorm number one, Envy has a Sunder. Is he going to get it off? He does just barely, but I still don't think he's got a way out of this one.
Oh,
trying to charge forward.
Saxka!
And Moose Chronos, it looks so impressive. They didn't actually kill him in the Chronos, so it doesn't get like all the style points, but man, that looked good.
Wow.
What a good sequence of events from DC.
Yeah, the Lion was just like super prepared too. Like, he was there with a double stun, like, almost instantaneously. And they blew up the Lion in the duration of an Earth Spike. And that was crazy fast. He even maxed mana drain. This is versus the TB plus SD, or SD plus any illusion hero, really, that we've seen quite often.
It makes sense. If he had the max hex, Arteezy dies, sure, but as far as the bigger game plan goes, the illusions are going to be the main problem.
And then we see a Yule's up on Mirana. This is one of the more curious items that we've seen, but it will help versus the...
Here we go. Jump in on Mu, gets turned around, Arteezy. Losing mana quickly with the mana drain. He's actually going to be completely depleted. Time dilation slowing him down a little bit as well, and they're going to just suicides from like full HP almost. I think he just realized without mana he wasn't getting out of that one. And Bulba, it's going to be close. The arrow not even needed. Slark with the Scotty picked up has a lot of essence shift, and Secret are just dropping like flies one by one.
Yep, they have lost all sense of control in this game.
Well, DC were ready for the split push game, and they have punished Secret handily.
Yeah, the Yules is really good for the mana leak. It's also really good at killing the Storm Spirit, and he doesn't have Aegis. He's actually in a little bit of trouble.
Oh my, 15 HP.
That would have been a big kill.
It's like you can stop the TPs out, like when you try and gank someone, you want to guarantee an arrow setup.
I think it's they can also kill the Storm very easily without the Lion, or if Lion's like slightly out of position. But
you can see what the game plan probably is going to be for Secret. Hope Envy carries you right now. His TB. Almost getting the Miranda there. Does end up killing off Misery on the Ogre Magi.
They have so many ways to deal with the illusions, though. Yep. So, like,
well, can they deal with the main TP?
Yeah, easily.
Yeah.
Chrono.
Hex.
I don't think you need a Chrono the Storm Spirit at this point, because he's, like, still very weak and doesn't have too many Bloodstone charges. DC will have Roche very soon, too.
Rezzo is starting into that scary territory as a Slark, where initially it looked like it was going to be a bit of a rough game, but Storm's Orchid is going to come incredibly late. Coddle is not really doing what you expected the hero to do, so all of Secret struggling here. I mean, Bulba's just kind of like a support. He's got the farm of a support, and he's the initiator. Anytime he blinks in, you kind of said it early, he's just instantly dead. He can't initiate fights.
He needs BKB, but that's not coming anytime soon.
That's ambitious.
One of the big worries for Secret and why I don't necessarily think they're like quite in top shape yet is because like it always falls back to this for Secret. Like they can't win like a straight up 5-on-5 like outplay. It's always like, okay, we need to split up and farm, or oh, we need to be cheeky with a morphling to side lanes and split push them to death. It's never feels like they just like thwomped them in straight up game of Dota. It's I'm not saying that like split pushing is not a straight up game of Dota, but it's you can do that occasionally, but if you do that every single game, especially in this patch, I don't think it's a great sign of strength.
And you look at the like looking for like Tien stuff, like I don't see that ever working against teams like OG, Liquid, Newbie, etc. I mean, DC Shark, it's not going to work against them, not at all. So
now they're trying cheeky stuff with like a recall into Zip to push out lanes.
Yeah,
you'll see like SD Illusions constantly spamming out lanes and trying to maybe do some damage to the supports, but it's going to be very little. Let's see if Moo can work his magic.
I guess high ground defense is definitely one of Secret's fortes with that recall.
Yeah, they need to strike combo during nighttime though.
Yeah.
Unless they want to smoke.
I think it was a game I saw, was it Alliance who did that, where they just kept doing that for like 20 minutes straight defending their high ground with a Storm Spirit Coddle.
Yeah, they actually don't have a pipe, nor do they have BKBs. So the Blinding Lion and the Illuminate are both like very annoying for the high ground.
We'll move going for the Ags. What's the shorter cooldown on the Chronosphere?
Not
more standard choice perhaps. And we picking up a ulti orb. Lincoln's, or do you think there's value in a Hex this game?
I think Hex. You could also go Scotty, but I don't think you need Scotty. He has Slark there to tank for him. Yeah. I'd be much more on board with the Scythe.
I mean, Scotty seems a bit weird if you're not going for a right-click build to begin with.
Yeah. Well, sometimes you need to tank up, but I don't think this game needs a tank.
Alright.
And there's, like, yeah. Yeah.
I don't know yet. Yep. Where I bet. Speak English to me.
Yeah. Good sir. About that.
Roche is back in DC. Seem to have their eyes somewhat set on that. I mean, the team fight of Secret is not something to be scared about. Even more so during the night, with Coddle's Axe being somewhat limited. And Arteezy caught out here. And the Observer Ward, the Bash comes in to fold up, and the Finger of Death. Saxka knew what he was doing all along, didn't even need the bash there. Goodbye Bloodstone charges for Arteezy. TB Diffusal.
Storm's farm is so slow this game.
Yeah. It looked like a decent Storm pick when we saw it as a fifth pick. I mean, now the game's played out, has it felt like the pick just wasn't as strong as we thought it was, or is it just been the overall play of Secret?
I think DC's playing incredibly well. I think the Lion in particular has been like just spot on with his positioning. He got his blink at a relatively early timing. He's like always there when he needs to be. I think Wii's been doing a good job of farming a lot too, which sounds easy, but it's actually not that easy because you're worried about Secret just constantly farming their jungle. And like sometimes the like inclination is to be there and disrupt their farm, you know, drop wards in here and there, like what you saw Misery kind of do when he died that one time by Slonesome. But he matched his farm with his own farm, and then once he gets strong enough with the Ags, then he can actually make plays around the map. But now we see him get a lot more involved, and Moose had some pretty good Chronospheres. I think overall, like DCs, they're playing very well. Some weird deaths here and there, but their game plan is very solid, and they're not chain feeding, which is super important for
against the Storm in general. But for DC, they've got Aegis now on Slark, and I mean, similar to the fact that their lineup doesn't take Roche that fast, they don't have the best physical damage. They don't actually siege or take towers. They're still tier 2s up, despite how big their lead is.
Their team fight's far superior, though, so...
They push high ground by killing heroes.
Oh, hi! Hi, Barlandai.
Oh, this could be a multiple 3-hero critter. It gets 2. Oh, Bulb actually blinks into it, so he does get 3. Envy, though, on the outside will scare Mu off, and the follow-up wasn't really there. Resolution in the front lines forced the Shadowdance very early because of the onslaught from the Terrorblade. Envy doing a lot of damage here. Haven't got the best control from him, and we will actually die. No buyback available. Resolution trouble as well. Dies once and could just die a second time here. They've got the detection sentry right on the ground. They're looking for the other heroes first. Resolution will be left alone, it looks like, with the Slaughter down. Secret's catch not quite there. Arteezy TPing back after the initial fight. Has an Orchid. Falls in far. Is he going to find Saxka? Far enough away with the four staff, and Arteezy didn't have the mana to continue chasing. Well, they got a good Chrono, but this is one of maybe we saw the draft and was like, what do you actually do damage in the Chrono with? And then we saw it there, like, there was no damage for the Chrono.
I think the teammates were a little bit far behind, but most of the time we see like a multiple man or spike from Lion, yes. But they just were not prepared.
And Mu didn't even, like, he saw two or three heroes he could Chrono, he didn't even Chrono right away because he recognized his team was far away, but then it just like got to a point where it's like, okay, something's about to happen, I gotta use this Chrono now, so.
They gotta be careful during daytime though, because of the Keeper, they can like position very well.
I mean, it's almost like a Nightstalker-esque game with the Slark with his night vision versus the Cotter with the day vision, where you've got to play around the night and day cycles very effectively. Envy getting found. Resolution's going to get a lot of essence shift charges here. Nothing happens. Pylai die, looking to help his buddy out. Rezo still going in, has the Abyssal, which he's holding on to, probably to stop the Sunder. BKB is there. Mu goes for the Chrono with the follow-up. DC not on the same page here.
You got to get out.
He's like, yeah, maybe he's like, ah, Scepter, I can use the 60 seconds, no big deal.
They could have, if he had Abyssaled there and then the Lion King with the Impale, could have, it looked like Rezo just had already accepted, oh, we're not killing this guy.
He popped BKB. When he popped BKB, you back out, you don't have any damage. Maybe Slark, but hitting a BKB hero in the Chronosphere as a Slark is very difficult, unless it's like, it's an amazing Chrono. And that was far from it.
Okay, so things stabilize a bit here. Storm's farm still very lacking. How's DC going to scale? If this game drags out another 10, 15, 20 minutes, are you worried for DC?
Not really. Resolution's mega farmed. Wii is mega farmed.
Yep.
Mu has Scepter, so like they have setup for the damage. And then I think both their support scale really well too. You're talking about like a Resolution who's already ready to farm. And then on top of that, you have Bloodlust. And then you have Soxa, who's amazing versus all these illusions. Mm-hmm. And they don't have like the most farm on their supports, but their skill set's good enough to carry them through the mid game that they don't actually need that many items, as long as they have their like blink or whatever one small item that they kind of need.
Level 4 Bloodlust always going to help out all your three cores.
Yep.
Do you think the Mirana wants to transition to any physical damage, or do you just go all out?
I think you just go all build. Spell build. Like at this point, it's a little bit too late to commit. I think maybe you can go like a Maelstrom, but I think like right click damage against a Terrorblade without any minus armor on your team is just not going to be that great.
If anything, you may just be better off going for the Shivers / like whatever.
EB.
Yeah, I think those EB kind of items.
And eventually you'll want a refresher on the Faces Void. And then this way, you don't even have to worry about the BKB on Terrorblade, he's ulti him twice.
And it feels like Secret, the last few fights have gone alright, but this is while TB has his long duration BKB. You look 10 minutes, 15 minutes down the line, if fights keep going kind of even, eventually it's going to be 5 seconds, and then TB might struggle a lot more. So DC, settle down for now.
They're getting like some anti-BKB stuff, like the Abyssal in particular is already like pretty decent. What did Mirana go for? Lincoln's, okay.
Yeah.
Lincoln's for what? Mana Leak?
The Orchid from Storm, perhaps, somewhat. Where is Yule's?
She has Yule's.
So.
That's a little curious. I think I would prefer the Scythe, so they actually have a better way to deal with the PKP, but maybe he doesn't want to all in on that because of the Shadow Demon.
If you time it right, you could try and stop a Sunder, but it's very obvious if you use it on a teammate, for example, and TB could just target someone else, maybe, so it's not. I feel like buying a Lincoln's to try and use it against Sunder is.
Yeah, Lotus, I think, would be much more useful. Yeah. But, or if you're trying to block Sunder, but maybe he just wants a little bit more sustain so he can keep farming out lanes.
I mean, Mana Leak's really annoying, because if it's like a Coddle Terrorblade, you get Mana Leak, you want to leap away, but TB just pounds onto you.
Typically, though, like, you might prefer Manta, too. Manta's also, like, pretty good versus the starter amp. Not that that's really that big of an issue for him, but he's also good versus Orchid.
We'll see what the plan's going to be. It looks like Secret, considering a movement out on the map, they're huddled up for now. It's nighttime, though. If anything, moving out of the map during nighttime, you can only do it under the cover of smoke. And it may just be safer to stay in your own base. Wait for DC to come to you. Use that high ground defense advantage.
They need to try and... Does Keeper have... gem? Yeah. They need to try and get this gem away from him.
I mean, unless Secret get wiped, this is going to be a long game. Storm...
He just popped BKB. God knows why. I guess trying to pop his Mantis down. But they might actually go off this, because I think that was the main thing that destroyed them last fight. And DC clearly got wind of that, as you see all the dots kind of head towards the secret base.
But then the Ball Lightning recall comes into play. We'll keep seeing this over and over again, probably for a while.
Yeah, they don't actually have any urns on DC. Like, I think urns actually go a long way into helping your base push. For random spam, like a hero that just beats on the tower while tanking a little bit, like
it. 07 found many kills recently. Like, yeah. 18 kills, like.
Well, not at this point. It's just a build up on, well, like the ogre, let's say.
What spellcaster? Dagon. No, not the E-blade, but
yeah,
Dagon 5 plus E-blade is always a possibility.
As long as it's magic damage, because magic damage is much better versus tier blade, and they have a veil, so it's a little bit stronger than 101 gold. No.
I mean, most expensive item in the game must be the best item in the game.
Bloodthorn?
A Dagon 5. Dagon 5 more?
Oh yeah, it is. Right. I think so. I think it's like 8,000 and Bloodthorn's like 7k something.
Storm. I wonder what, BKB perhaps next, or what do you think?
I think so. Just so he can kill Lion.
There's no physical damage is not what DC are building at all this game. So no point getting like a Shivers really as I see it. But yeah, BKB. It's not that, some kind of damage output, but you're a Storm.
I think DC might actually need more armor too. I don't really know who would build it, but maybe they can just kite with Ghost too. Like, Ogre's like innately pretty tanky. I guess the Veil is also pretty useful, but they need to survive during the Terrorblade slaughter.
Yeah. And we saw a few times where it's like TB's in Metamorph, and when there's a fight around him and he's not being controlled, he's BKB right clicking people, like Misery melted, the Mirana actually melted. That was Wee dying in the last fight, so.
Mm-hmm.
That's where you often see like the Shivers pick up, but not the case here. Mu jumped on. Looks like he's going for a Manta for that silence, but. Wasn't really a kill attempt, more just some wave clear coming out from Arteezy. As Aegis expires, DC don't even really make a wholehearted attempt to push high ground with the Aegis. Now Secret, as soon as Aegis expired, it's daytime. They smoke up. This is, I mean, I'd say a really good timing, perhaps a predictable timing when no one's going to be showing on the map, but this is the time to strike, yeah.
They do see the Slark very soon, maybe?
Saxka and we both popping up in the mid lane. Envy. Ready to go. Bulba's going to be the initiator here. He's going to be very fast on the follow-up.
It's been far too long. Now they expect the fight man.
No one's pushing out top. That's like the biggest tell. When no one's pushing out a wave that's on your tier 3 tower, it doesn't get much more obvious than that.
If Slaughter were more farmed, then Arteezy wouldn't have to be there, and then they could recall him, but he's not farmed enough to make the jump on his own.
You need like the insta follow-up from Storm, the recall.
Yeah, it's too slow.
Yeah.
But it would have been less obvious and maybe a better success rate even for their gank.
To the Roche pit, initially go DC, but they're getting a bit nervous here.
Daytime versus a Storm and Keeper, I don't think it's that safe. And I think the Terrorblade can also thrive inside
the
pit.
They're invising in. Dagon, it's teasing the Impale from Saxka again, got a mid. Ball lightning animation, the Chrono catches up to Pilot Eye and Envy. Envy's got no disruption to help him out. Pi on the back of that Chronosphere gets taken out. Resolution was caught in it, but the damage was done elsewhere from DC. Great team fight. The arrow to initiate catches out Arteezy and then the Chrono from Mu.
Yeah, nice hex too, so that TB didn't pop his BKB in time.
DC's team fight execution has been. Yeah. Well, apart from that one fight above the tier 2 mid.
I think Sox has been playing like amazingly well this game. Like, he's been super quick on the Lion.
Well, now we're ready to go high ground. Double buyback from Shadow Demon Storm, and this is the call to just start pushing out these lanes if you're Secret. Spam that Ball Lightning. Doesn't want to get Hexed or anything. We're looking for him. was Saxka, but Arteezy fast with the double ball lightning.
Moo, is this chrono almost up?
Yeah, except 5 seconds, yeah.
Yeah, they're...
And the creep wave, they're on high ground without backdoor protection. At least they were initially, yeah. They're still not finding backdoor protection, so Arteezy's efforts to clear the creep wave kind of in vain here. This Moo doesn't want to lose his entire mana pool. Does have cheese. If he, a good opportunity to Chronosphere presents itself, but hey, Melee Rex. Kind of reset now and wait for that next good teamfight initiation. That's the thing. There's no real scary initiation from Seeker. So if you're DC, you can wait and wait. Wait till you hit an arrow like that in Arteezy. Wait till you hit that good Chronosphere, because you're not really scared of Seeker, if anything. You're just scared of the Terra Blade.
Yeah, without BKBs on their two initiators, like, they're gonna die if they jump in. Especially if Lion is quick to react, so...
So for DC, it's just kinda like, try and again. Eventually you hit a Chrono, hit an arrow, hit a 2-3 here Impale. Well, we hit a lot of those this game, and you take that fight, so...
45 seconds left of daytime, EE with DD, this could be the best fight that they could hope for.
I feel like Secret at some point is gonna say, let's go for it.
Yeah, but DC, well, we see... Resolution kind of going in there. He does have the Aegis.
Is there a gem on
okay,
Secret?
He knows.
Rezo, gosh, immediately blows up the Shadow Demon. No protection for the Puppy Keeper of the Light. Storm falls over the Chronosphere, but Saxka's there with the finger. Gem aside, True Sight hits the deck. Envy BKB'd up. Now he's got the Metamorph. Is this going to be in time? He's got double damage, doing a lot of right click, but the bash, the control from Resolution. It's good. Is it good enough? He gets the Shadow Dance off at the end as well. Bulba going to go down, and that's a team wipe from Digital Chaos.
Nice try. That was the best shot they were gonna get, but Resolution scouted them out with the Aegis, and
they just prioritize kills well. Like take out Shadow Demon, then take out one more.
Solid Chronos from Moo.
His Chronos were good this game, but like you say, Saxka's Lion.
Saxka's Lion. Wow, that was. I liked watching that.
I'm gonna give, yeah, I mean DC. They.